Hey guys, welcome to the Clubhouse. I'm Billy Jackson, and today's review is going to be on Star Wars, The Rise of Skywalker. Whew! This is going to be an extremely hard review to do because I can't really say anything about this movie without giving away every spoiler that's in the movie, because there's a lot of spoiling to be done in this movie. And the reason for that being is there is a lot going on in this movie. It can't just be a simple plot point, run to that, bam, done. This movie has like four different plots going on. Now, I will say at the beginning that I did like the movie. But I have to see it again to really get a good hold on whether I liked this movie or didn't like this movie, to be honest with you. Because when I first walked out, I was like, man, that's not as bad as, you know, people on the internet are saying. You know, this is actually a really good movie. But then thinking about some of the plot holes that were in this movie, I mean, huge, huge plot holes. They have so much going on with no explanation on how this happened or how that happened. I just left going, well, what about this and what about that? And so much is going on. I mean, this movie moves at a breakneck speed. I mean, from the very first second to the last second, it's just boom, you know, and which is fun, you know, and that made the movie entertaining. But it's Star Wars. I need more meat on my bones. I need more story, you know, character development. And I felt like this was a movie that could have done without the first two, The Force Awakens and The Last Jedi. And, you know, I didn't really like The Last Jedi that much. I love Force Awakens. Force Awakens is awesome. I didn't really like The Last Jedi that much. And this is definitely better than The Last Jedi. You know, I didn't walk out. I walked out of Last Jedi going, God, I hated this movie. But I did not hate this movie. I really liked it. Just some of the choices that they make in this movie, I think were kind of convoluted and not warranted, and they were kind of disappointing for me. But like I said, I really need to see it again before I can give a great, you know, opinion on it. You know, I like the movie. I just didn't like some of the choices that the movie made, you know, if that makes sense. I'm trying to make sense of it in my head because this movie really, like, blew my mind. And that's a good thing. You know, it's good to think about movies and to you know, especially Star Wars. You know, it's my favorite franchise of all time. And, you know, this is the last one of the Skywalker series. And I did like the way the movie ended. I liked the last 5 minutes of this movie a lot. And I liked the whole movie. But, you know, my buddy that I went with, he did not like the ending. So we kind of debated about, you know, what happens and why we felt the way we felt about the ending. And like I said, I need to see this movie again. It's a movie that has to be seen multiple times because there's so much going on. Like I said, there's multiple plot points. You know, there's a lot of MacGuffins they have to get. You know, we got to go on a quest to get this. And once we get this, it'll lead us to another artifact that'll lead us to this. Oh, and while this is all going on, this happens. Now we got to go and do this so we can get back to doing this so we can get to the end. And when you do that in 2 hours, it just feels rushed. You know, that's the biggest word I can think about this movie. It felt like that they didn't have a plan when they did Force Awakens. You know, like they went into Force Awakens, like this is how we're going to set it up. Then, you know, Last Jedi comes out, and honestly, you don't even need to see The Last Jedi for this movie. I mean, honestly, unless you just want to know what happens to Luke. You know, if you're wondering in this movie, why is Luke like that? The Last Jedi explains it. But that's all The Last Jedi really did. And that's what I didn't like that was in this movie, about how it wasn't enough setup and character development in the first two films that will make stuff that happens in this film make sense. You know, there's so much going on that you have questions about. Like, how did that happen? You know, where did they get that? You know, I mean, where did they get this whole fleet of Star Destroyers? You know, and they don't explain anything. I mean, I felt like this movie did not explain one thing. Okay, they explained a couple of things, but very minute one-liners of an explanation. It wasn't like, they took the time to really make you feel like what they're trying to explain to you matters. And that's the only thing that left me, coming out of this film going, gosh, I have more questions than answers. And this movie does answer some major questions that were left over in the first two movies, but it still left me with more questions. And I just, that's the part I didn't like about it. I just feel like, I just wish they wouldn't have rushed this movie, and I feel like it was rushed. But then again, I need to see it one more time before I can really tell you if I really like it or love it. I didn't hate it at all. It's not a bad movie. It's a great movie. I mean, it was fun. But like I said, a lot of plot holes going on, and that's kind of stuff that I notice and pick up on. A lot of quick editing. They just go from scene to scene to scene to scene in a lot of moments, and I don't like it when films do that. I want them to lull me into this, bam, this. I wanted them to stick the landing. I'm just trying to think of the words to say because I don't want to spoil anything. But I will see this movie again this weekend, and I will put up a spoiler video either Sunday or Monday, just so I can get out all my stuff that I had, the problems and the stuff that I really loved about this movie. And one of the things I really loved about this movie is the use of Leia. So I'm glad that they did her. They gave her the respect that she deserved in this movie, and I really like that. A lot of great things that I like, and I know I nitpick a lot, but you'll see when you go see it that it's just bam, 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 bam in your face the whole time. And they give you a lot of stuff, but then they don't tell you why they're giving you this. So that's the only problem I have with it. Overall, good movie. If you're a Star Wars fan, go into this and you'll love it. And you might have the same issues that I did, but like I said, I'm gonna see it again. I'll do a spoiler video for you guys so I could get it all out because I really can't tell you anything without spoiling the entire movie because the whole movie is one big spoiler. So that being said, have you seen The Rise of Skywalker? Are you planning on seeing it? Let me know in the comments below. Remember to like my videos and subscribe to my channel. And as always, make yourself happy every day. And the only way to do that is to remember the only thing stopping you is you stopping. Bam!